Hey, my you ladies and my you gents, I'm Stephen Tosher, and on today's episode of our Thoughtful Thursdays, I'm going to be telling you about car safety. Now, some of you may be thinking, car safety, Steve? What does that have to do with anything about the body, mind, and spirit? Well, it has lots to do with the body, mind, and spirit when you think about it. Imagine you get into an accident. Chances are you're going to hurt your body. Chances are you're going to see something, or you might have a concussion, or there might be some form of neurological damage that happens. Hopefully it doesn't, but it can. And on the spiritual side of things, imagine if you again see something, or you have to live with the fact that you hurt someone, or someone hurt you, and it was to do with maybe one of multiple situations, whether it be weather, whether it be a situation where someone's playing on their phone, or drunk driving, or even being tired at the wheel. So, you know, the body, mind, and spirit is definitely affected. The reason why I'm telling you about this is hopefully it can prevent a situation where I have to practice what I preach, and you have to tuck away your ego and your pride, even if you do understand the car fairly well, and or a situation fairly well, and you just need to be very aware of your surroundings, which I talk about a lot, getting proper rest, just doing things to make you safe and make you healthy. Now, before I continue with the story, I just want to give you kind of an analogy. For instance, if you hurt your right ankle, and then you hurt your left ankle a couple weeks later, a couple years later, and it feels the same, it might not be the same. It might be a different situation altogether, and if you don't get the proper attention that it needs, it could get worse very fast, right? And you may not be able to treat it properly. So just like with your car, you have to do the same thing. So let me just jump into my story quickly. So, and there will be pictures as well. So I'm driving my car. She turns 19 years old. I call her she. Her name is Amarjita. I know guys and calling girls, I don't know what is wrong with us, but I have a couple friends named Gita, and it was just, she was an older car that I got, and I knew a Amarjita grandmother, so I don't know. It's kind of a respect thing / car thing, but my car has been fantastic. It's run for many, many years. I have put a lot of money into it. However, it's an older car. It is what it is. And I should have been looking for a car for a long time, but I haven't. And that was a lack of awareness, and that was a bit of ego and pride. I wanted to see how long I could get out of this car. So I'm driving the car, and it's starting to shake quite violently. And I'm talking like shake, 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 shake. So I end up with a couple friends diagnosing the problem. It's my brakes, and especially it's my caliper. The caliper is just holds the brake, and it either squeezes the brakes together like on a bicycle type brake, or you know, it'll squeeze to the outside depending on the way your car is built. So anyway, the caliper, as it was squeezing the brakes, it was sticking, and the brakes had basically ground down to almost nothing. And that's a very, very bad situation. So that's really what had caused the shaking. So after we changed it, everything was fine. You know, I do my weekly checks. There was no issues. I, you know, get down on my hands and knees, check to see if there's any dust coming from the brakes or anything like that, metal fibers or anything like that, nothing. And a week later, it started to shake very, very, you know, lightly. Then it got heavier, and then a week later, it got really heavy. And then it was actually shaking worse, even worse than it was before. And I was thinking to myself, just like I told you about with the right ankle to the left ankle, oh, it must be the same thing. You know, it's the passenger side, whatever. I walk around the car, I check the bolts on it, make sure everything's okay on the right side. And here I am, not really, you know, either checking the rest of the car or seeing, you know, beyond the skin deep of the car. So again, I walked around the car and it got worse and worse. And then about 2 weeks ago, it was shaking horrible. I've never been in a car shake so violently in my life. And I'm like, I have to park this thing. So I was only driving it around to go check out dealerships. And to be honest with you, as you all know, if you've been watching the series, I've been really stressed. A lot of money, family, friend issues, psychological situations have been going on, as well as some depression and this and that. And I just seen a lot and been through a lot this past year. In a lot of ways, a lot of the things in my life haven't gone the way, as many of you would know, the way you want them to. I think everyone has that. But in particular, the past month has been really, really rough, and I didn't need to add a car to it, which is lots and lots of money, lots of potential headaches, and puts me further in the hole. I don't know where I'll be in the future with this series, but put me further in the hole. So I'm looking for a new car. And by the grace of God, as all things happen in my life, my sister saw someone pointing down at the bottom of the car. And from the position she was pointing, it looked like it was my driver's side. And I'm like, what? What's going on? I've checked the car before. It wouldn't be the shaking. There's no way that the caliper is ruined on the right side. On the left side as well as the right side. So I pull over to the side, and to my horror, I look down and I see this, and I'll show you the picture now. the bolts on the car either to do with me not tightening them properly, and I'll take full responsibility for that, or the bolts coming off on their own slowly, which I don't think happened. I do blame myself for this. The tire was actually shaking so violently that it had cut off the prongs where the bolts once were, and it was hanging on by very, very small amounts of metal. And in my heart of hearts, it sank all the way into my toes. And I realized that I could have injured somebody on the road. I could have injured a passenger. I could have hurt myself. And I could have definitely hurt people inside the car that are usually very, very close to me. I do drive other people home, but anyone in my car is like family immediately. And anyone outside that I interact with outside of my car, even if they're not nice to me, I still think of them as family, because on the road, it is serious business. And my pride and my ego nearly created a situation that was not going to be good for anybody. I thought for sure there's no way that it couldn't be the caliper on the right side. And of course, it was not the caliper on the right side. So to make a long story short, yes, you know what? The shaking was so close, if not basically the same type of shaking, that most people couldn't have recognized that or seen that. And granted, on the look arounds that I did in past, I couldn't have seen it until the bolts and everything started coming off, which I assume they did on the highway when I was driving the 2 days before when I parked the car finally. But at the end of the day, I should have still taken it to a mechanic. And I hope this story maybe helps you as a person who owns a car with those noises and those clunks and clanks that happen from time to time. And or if you know somebody who has a car, and or who's someone who's treating their body like that situation, or a situation where they think it's that, but you know they just aren't going to go that extra mile to check. Don't get yourself in a bad situation. Check your ego and pride at the door. You don't always know everything. I clearly don't know a heck of a lot, because I wouldn't have put myself in that situation if I did. And I just wanted to share that story with you. I hope this causes you to go out and check your cars even tonight. Not to be paranoid, but just with everything you do, take that little extra bit of care. You know, rest a little bit longer. Don't put yourself in a bad situation. And hug the people around you. That's kind of what I did. I just went around and started saying what's up to all those people, because when you're in a situation where you could have been in a very, very bad situation, maybe even a life-threatening situation, because I'm telling you, if that tire had come off on the highway, the car, I think, could have flipped. I could have hit someone very badly. It could have hurt somebody. And yeah, I just am very thankful to God, and I'm thankful to that person that I may never get to meet. Hopefully you're watching this video, and if you are, thank you so much for pointing out to my sister at McCowan and Ellesmere as I was turning left, like the end of November, early December in 2013. Thank you so much for, trying to get my attention and making sure that my angled tire that was about to fall off didn't fall off. So with that, if you have a comment or question, throw it down below. If you want to call me a fool, I totally deserve that. That's cool as well. Thank you so much for watching, and be safe, everybody. Have yourself a wonderful day, evening, morning, or night. God bless. Oh yeah, and if you like what I'm doing, please
tweet,
tumble, like, share, thumbs up, plus
pin,
or do whatever you do, and please subscribe.